wanna lay right here, get lost under the stars, and took all of my life to get where you are. I wanna stay right here, the light in my dark. Fate found us, it was no false alarm.
My name is Justin Reggiano, and I work at Chronic Ink Tattoos, located at 2352 Yonge Street and inside the Pacific Mall. We specialize in Asian tattoos, Asian art, sorry. That's where we started from 5 years ago, and it's got us to where we are today. But that's the kind of the bread and butter of what our niche is. But now, with 18 artists, we kind of do everything other than Asian. But still, it is our most predominant style that everyone knows us for. Our shop is very open, it's an open space. We always want our clients to feel very comfortable in our studio. We don't want them to feel scared walking in here, even though a tattoo process is a scary thing. That's not the purpose of what we want. People, we want people to feel like they can take off their clothes and give us their skin in a comfortable scenario. And that's the kind of atmosphere we bring. We're very, very transparent, very open. People on social media do see us and see what we do every day and hear about our stories and hear about our apprentices. The first thing is always a consultation, and that usually starts with an inquiry of some sort. That can be through email, through our social media, or by phone. We always like to do it in person, but people do live far away, so we can do it over email, and that's really the beginning process of it, is finding out what the client wants to get. And then from there, we kind of build on from there. So we first inquire, we find out what they want to get, figure out in terms of what subjects they want to get and will they fit in that area. So the client usually goes crazy and they say, I want to get this and this and this in this area. And then we go in and tell them what's possible and who's best suited out of our 18 artists to execute the piece to its best ability. After that's done, we book them with that artist. The clients usually give us full freedom in terms of the art part of it, the way it looks. As we always want to make sure it's in the best interest of the art and it looks its best on the skin. And then the process depends on how big the piece is. So if it's a larger piece, it's done in sessions, which with a 3-week break in between, and only doing about 4 hours in each session. And then we just continue that process until the tattoo is done. A lot of practicing, a lot of drawing, they draw a lot. They also practice on things like grapefruits, pig skin, and artificial skin. Now, each thing obviously emulates different things. The grapefruit obviously does not emulate physical skin. It's more of the contour of the body. And then the pig skin is more of actual skin to get a feel for stretching and tattooing. And then artificial skin is actually more like rubber. So just gives them a feel of tattooing on the skin. They're pretty much either watching an artist, absorbing as much as they can, asking a million questions, drawing nonstop, and then helping out the shop in terms of keeping up, upkeeping everything else. So basically they're always busy and always working.
Definitely have a lot of people, we call them virgins, come to the shop. Yeah. It's so important to talk to all your clients, whoever walks in, talk to them, make them relax, make them feel comfortable the moment they walk into the shop. I just will connect with them and relax them, just talking to them, like tell them how it feels like. It feels like a sunburn, a bad sunburn. When I got my first tattoo, I was 18 years old, and I got it on a whim, sort of. I had an idea that I wanted for a while, and I just picked a random shop. I went in, and they were kind of making me feel like I shouldn't have gotten the tattoo at the time. There's one of those things where like they're not necessarily trying to talk you out of it, but they kind of want to mold the tattoo into what they want it to be, which I kind of understand now. And you know, he was really patient, especially because I was like, why is it taking so long? Why is it taking so long? Because I didn't realize how long it was supposed to take. I thought it would be like outlining and then done, but then when you actually learn how to do it, you realize how you have to be patient with it. You can't rush a tattoo, or else if you rush it, it's going to end up badly. And so it was more, that was a learning experience in and of itself.
It was way back when, the moment I turned 18,
I just walked into this sketchy place and be like, hey, I want a tattoo. And then, you know, it was just, first it was a quote, just a one liner script dream on my wrist. And then afterwards, every summer I will start adding more and more and more. And, you know, you don't regret it in the end, because the experience overall of being at the shop and meeting different people was exhilarating. Well, it's something that I've been interested in since I was like a little kid, actually, because I used to watch all of those shows on TV, like LA Ink, Miami Ink. And then after a while, because I just graduated from art school, and I didn't really know what I wanted to do afterwards, and so I was thinking about careers that would help me integrate fine art with something that was actually tactile rather than being on the computer working in like Photoshop, Illustrator, because my parents are product designers, and so their business is really computer based, and I realized I didn't really want that kind of office job life. And so I was looking for different career paths that would offer me the ability to like use my fine art practice in a way that would actually be like a really awesome job.
I can't picture myself doing anything else. I was in illustration for school, and it's all about business, about being in an office, it's about constantly throwing yourself portfolios all over. You have to keep, you put yourself in an edge all the time. And at least at the shop, you meet a lot of great people, and it's just the whole environment. It feels like I belong here. That's all. I just can't picture myself anywhere else.
Okay, not that bad. It was just a simple script. It was a little nerve-wracking at the beginning, because I'm like, oh my god, am I ready for this? And then, but you zone in the moment you touch the machine and you touch the needle in the skin, you just zone in and you just focus. And then I think afterwards, it's really rewarding when they, after they get their tattoo, that they just smile at you, they give you like a thank you, and then they give you a tip after, just like, I don't know. I don't know what to feel after that. It just makes me feel a little jittery.
It's getting better. I mean, everyone still has that stigma of tattoos are for people that are like rebellious, or you know, that are bad people. That stigma is kind of fading away, and I think a lot more of it is looking at the art aspect of it. Instagram's helped a lot with that, and a lot of social media's helped with that, people getting educated more, but I still think that there's still a bit of some kind of a stigma to it in different corporate elements. People do want to still cover their tattoos when they're in the office. They always tell us they don't want to go too far because they wear dress shirts and so on and so forth, but I think it's becoming a little bit more acceptable. It's not 100% yet. I mean, I don't think everyone loves it, but we focus on the art a lot, and I think that's why people love us, and we care about how much it looks versus how much we can make, because at the end of the day, the art is really what brings people back. And I think it's what really puts us forward, is we focus a lot on the art. And I mean, it's helped us get 40 awards. So there's conventions that happen across Canada, across the world actually. And we compete in a lot of them in Canada. We've only competed in Philadelphia once this year, and we won 2 awards there. But you compete with the pieces you want to submit, and there's different categories, which is like best sleeve, best back and gray, so on and so forth. And we've been able to take a good number home, which helps us a lot. I mean, it's not something we brag about, but it's something that definitely helps us people understand that we do care about how it looks. Yeah, I mean, okay, I'll be honest, like, this area is horrible. You'll hear a lot of people talk about the inner bicep being a lot more painful, but I mean, it's always withstandable. If it wasn't, I don't think a lot of people would get it, but it is painful. I mean, we're going 2 millimeters into your skin with a needle, so it is an annoying pain, but everyone takes it differently. We find that women take pain better than men. That's not a fact, this is just what we notice in our shop, but they do say that women do take pain better, because at the end of the day, all we want to put out there is good work. Maybe a sketch to a tattoo, but that's really what our focus is making good artwork and making good tattoos and making the industry kind of rise from being so frowned upon sometimes. Like, definitely make people understand this is a great career and a great industry to be a part of, and it may seem negative at times, but definitely has a lot more positives.